The real-life Dracula was born in 1431 in Transylvania. His name was Prince Vlad Tepes. His father was called Dracul, meaning the devil, because he was a fearsome warrior. His son, Vlad Tepes, adopted the name Dracula, meaning son of Dracul. Dracula was also a very fierce warrior and showed no mercy for his enemies. Through his reputation, he became known as Vlad the Impaler for his sadistic torturing techniques and ruthless killings. Although torturing and executing your political opponents was not uncommon in the 15th century, Vlad's atrocities were unimaginable. His methods were so vicious, they were said to have been used by Ivan the Terrible in Russia. Vlad's usual method of killing was impalement with a spear or large stake. His victims were then hoisted high into the air so all could see. But Vlad added variations and specialized in a sadistic art form. He impaled from the front, back, and side, through the stomach, navel, breast, and groin. He impaled from above while his victims hung upside down, and with rounded off stakes to prolong the torture. He impaled by sex, age, and rank, and had the stakes arranged in geometric patterns and at different heights. He added embellishments, driving nails through the heads, cutting off limbs, noses, ears, and sex organs. He dabbled in strangulation, burning, boiling in oil, and blinding. He showed no mercy, even to the innocent. On one occasion, he called together some 400 students who were in Wallachia, studying the language and customs. He locked them in a large room and burned down the building. On another occasion, he impaled an entire town of 20,000 after the merchants refused his orders. As the torturing commenced, Vlad ate a hearty meal and enjoyed the proceedings. A papal legate, the Bishop of Arezzo, who had no reason to exaggerate, reported that Vlad Tepes had authorized the killing of 100,000 people during his lifetime. This real-life monster was far more evil than Bram Stoker could have ever hoped to instill in his vampire character. But while Stoker's vampire character did evoke fear, the Count also aroused our sensuality, pity, and a host of other emotions. Combine his overwhelming power with the sexual prowess and immortal life, and it's easy to see why the vampire has captured our imagination. Hundreds of other vampire stories began to appear in books and later on the theatrical stage. Notable clergy, such as Montague Summers, began to write about vampires and their possible existence. By the turn of the century, the vampire was firmly dug in the genres of literature and theater. His next victim was the emerging film industry. The first vampire movie was titled Nosferatu. This silent classic featured Max Schreck as the gruesome vampire and was directed by F.W. Murnua. The film incorporates many of the characteristics of the folkloric vampire, the monstrous appearance, the long fingernails, and the unsophisticated manner. To this day, Nosferatu stands as a unique precursor to the entertainment industry's love affair with the vampire.